All right, YouTubers, DMan2000 here, back to continue our discussion of modes and scales. Today we're going to talk about pentatonics and how we can incorporate them into our groups of four concept in order to allow us to easily switch back and forth between pentatonics and between various modes of the major scale. And that has a lot of usefulness because pentatonics are very common scales in most types of popular music, and we're going to concentrate on the position 4 and position 5 box shapes, which are fairly easy to memorize because of their symmetry compared to the other shapes that you find in the other positions. So hopefully this will give us more notes to be able to choose from and allow us to switch back and forth between pentatonic scales and modes without having to memorize all 5 scale positions up and down the neck, just like we did with the groups of 4. And today we're going to talk about the C major scale and the C pentatonic scale. And so the C major pentatonic scale. Now the pentatonic scales are contained within the major scale, and pentatonic simply just means 5 notes or 5 tones. And so instead of 5 tones, or instead of 7 tones like a major scale, we're only going to use 5. And so we're going to leave out the 4th and the 7th, which in the case of C major are the F and the B notes, and we're going to play the 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6 notes, which are C, D, E, G, and A. And so let's start. We're going to start, and we're going to referencing the C major scale, which is going to be our 3rd finger here on the 8th fret on the low E string. And what we said about that in the past is that we have a group of 4 on the top 2 strings. We would actually start back here on the 5th fret with the 1st finger, and then we would have our 2nd finger on the 7th fret, 3rd finger on the 8th, which is our major root, and pinky on the 10th. And what we said about that was that these are our modal roots. So this A is an A minor or Aeolian root. This was a Locrian root. This is our major or Ionian root. And this is our Dorian root. And so what I want to point out, and then of course we would drop down here and complete our second group of 4, and that would give us our C major scale. And so what I want to point out here is that here, starting on the 5th fret, we have a position 5 or major pentatonic shape that's available to us that's also in the key of C. It's the same notes as the key of C, again without the 4th and 7th or the F and B. So what we're doing is we're just skipping 2 of the notes. And the way that works is we would start with our 1st finger on the 5th fret, and we would play that note, drop our pinky down on the 8th fret, which is our C note, which is our root, then drop down to the A string, and we would play 5-7, 5-7 on the D, 5-7 on the G, then we would go back to our 5-8 on the B and E strings, okay? So going backwards, it looks like this. And so what we've just done there is we've played a C major pentatonic scale, and we have been able to reference it to this note, which would be our major or Ionian root. And so, you know, if we were playing a group of 4 on this top string, and again, it doesn't really matter what note you start on, but we would have this box available to us. So, we've got this note is in both our group of 4 and our pentatonic shape, and then so are these 2 notes. And then, you know, down here, of course, we have starting you know, up on the seventh fret is our first note of our middle group. So we can go between C pentatonic and our, you know, our C major scale, or our Ionian C scale, and then from here on the bottom two strings, you know, that's our four notes available on the two high strings within our major pentatonic box, and then our group of four starts two frets up on here on the 10th fret. So if I wanted to play a group of four, you know, Ionian C scale, and then jump back into C pentatonic, I could just shift back to here. I just slipped the blue note in. We'll talk about that probably in a future lesson, because the pentatonic scale, the blue scale, is a hybrid, I guess you could say, of the minor pentatonic scale, which we'll talk more about in another lesson. And so trying to keep these lessons short, and I think that the last thing that I want to point out is that in addition to this major or position five box that you have available around your groups of four, you also would have a diagonal pentatonic scale that would start on the root of the C. So we said this is our third finger root for our group of four. If we start here, we have what some people call a 3/2 or frying pan shape that's also a major pentatonic scale, and we would be simply playing the C root on the eighth, a note on the 10th, the 12th, and we would drop down here to the 10th fret on the 5th string and play these two notes, which are going to be G and A, because that's our A, you know, the open string is A, this note is A because the neck repeats at the 12th fret, and then we're going to drop down from there and play another three. So we can either, you know, do it like that, or we can slide over to it, and then we're going to have right below that on the G string another two, and then we are going to shift one fret over and play another three and a two, and that's going to take us all the way to the 17th fret. And so looking at that again, what we have is okay, and so that is another alternative way to play a pentatonic scale. It's not a box per se. It's more similar to our group of four pattern, where we're playing three notes over two notes, and you know, moving one string down and two frets up the neck. And so when we look at that, and we say, you know, okay, we've got, and then we look at where our groups of four are, and you know, so this is our eighth string C root, so we've got a group of four starting here, so, and then when we jump down here on these strings, and then we look at you know, how our that where these notes overlap, and so and you know, they overlap at several positions, so it's fairly simple once you start to practice and master that to go from playing diagonal pentatonics to your major scales or modes, you know, in the same key. So now we have our three groups of four in the key of C. We have a major pentatonic box that goes across all six strings from the fifth fret that we can utilize, and then we also have our 3/2 shape that we can use starting at the 8th fret, and that will take us all the way to the 17th fret. And so that's pretty much it for today. If you know, have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments section, and we will see you next time. Peace out.